Poland Daily Business Edition, and tonight our guest is Marcin Roszkowski of the Jagiellonian Institute. Sir, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Let us say a few words about electricity prices in Poland. That's like foundation of the economy, the price both for consumers and for the industry. And as consumer, we pay less than, for example, the citizens of Germany, but as industry, we pay significantly more. Is that situation to be continued? Can Polish government do something to reduce that price?
Okay, so the prices in Poland for the households are protected, and there is a consensus to protect these prices. It's called the G tariff, and all the certain tariffs under households are protected. And this kind of consensus is present. Everybody accepts this approach of the government. Also, the opposition party support this kind of support. The problem is with the rest of the economy, because Polish energy sector is heavily dependent on coal generation. Whether it's lignite or hard coal, it's more or less 80%. And it's heavily influenced by the rise of CO2 emissions, which actually brings the Polish competitiveness of Polish energy sector to a very low level. So generally, the prices for industry, the prices of energy for industry, is higher in Poland than, for example, in Germany, which actually influences the competitiveness of Polish economy as a whole. So generally, the problems are there. So the energy transformation needs to speed up, especially that the coal sector is also having its trouble. For example, the lignite plants are, the lignite mines are running out of coal, and in mid-30s they will be exhausted. And also the hard coal generation, based on Polish hard coal, is suffering because Polish coal production decreases more or less 3-4% annually.
Right, and but the coal price is actually rising, the new plants are being added to the system in China and in India.
But new plants in Poland, the last one is being built in Ostrołęka with a lot of trouble, which actually the financial closing is not there. The coal consumption, the hard coal consumption is not decreasing, but the production is decreasing. So generally we are digging up the coal that is more and more expensive.
That's true. there is also an idea of European Union. We heard from Ursula von der Leyen, the new chief of European Commission, that the climate change is something that will be addressed, and that's the one of the first or the most important things which this commission will do.
Next year there is a plan to have our own European Green New Deal, like one of the American senators is proposing. The European Green New Deal is based on a further reduction of emissions, which actually means that the 40% reduction will be replaced by 50% reduction by the year 2030, which actually will heavily hit Polish energy sector and Polish competitiveness. So the energy transformation is necessary. More or less you could see that or hear that during the expose of Prime Minister Morawiecki last week. He was addressing the climate issues and also energy issues with the high attention because these prices will be rising. There is an impulse of these prices to be rising as long as we generate energy on coal in such a large quantity.
There is also new ministry for the first time in history, Poland. We have a climate ministry. And do you have idea what actually this ministry will do?
I think it's, the climate minister will serve as a kind of a interface between what is happening in Poland and what will be the negotiation position of Poland. The minister is Michał Kurtyka. He's a former president of COP24, so the United Nations agenda on climate policy is what he was managing for the time being in Polish government. He was also the deputy minister of energy and also deputy minister of environment, so he is experienced in selling the Polish agenda. But generally there are more than five or six ministers or deputy ministers concentrating on energy, because there is also kind of a treasury ministry, which actually also has a deputy minister for mining sector, for oversight of the Polish utilities, as state-controlled utilities producing energy. There's also Madam Minister Emilewicz, responsible for the rest of the economy. So there are several ministers coordinating the work on energy transformation. Let's see how it turns out. Having one minister for energy had its own benefits and problems.
Polish proverb in this case is, if there is too many cooks, you will not have anything to eat.
There is a very good German word for that, and that the answer is Jein. So it's yes and no in one word.
Well, we will see. That's very interesting development, definitely, and will concern very much the Polish economy in the upcoming years. Sir, thank you very much for this conversation. Marcin Roszkowski of Jagiellonian Institute was our guest tonight.